All right, so this is a 25 watt home energy access system and it runs on a 40 watt solar panel. This is a commercially available small 40 watt solar panel available at around 80 to 100 rupees per watt. So the total cost of the solar panel would be around 4000 to 5000 rupees at max. Then this is a Samsung commercially available AC-DC 12 watt LED TV. It's a 23 inch HD high contrast ratio LED TV capable of playing 1080 pixels per square inch. And this commercially sells at around $250, so roughly about 14,000 to 15,000 rupees in the African market, and consumes only 12 watts also. And this is standard cell phone charger. This is a radio, each consuming about half watt to a watt each. Then these two are the LED lamps. So this is the LED bulb, about 5 watts, commercially available everywhere in the world. Retails for about 200 to 300 rupees. This is an LED tube light, about 2 watts, and both are available in the retail market. The lumen efficiency is very high, in the ballpark of 80 to 100 lumens per watt, and the measured lumen efficiency is actually higher than 100. So 80 to 100 is the manufacturer defined lumen efficiency. And this is a brushless DC fan, retails for about 1000 to 1200 rupees, consumes only about 5 to 6 watt depending on the speed setting that you choose. So the highest speed would be about 6 watt, the lowest speed would be about 5 watts and so on. So the whole system, 5 watts for the fan, 6 to 7 watts for the lighting system, 1 watt for the cell phone charger and the radio, and 12 watts for the TV, consumes only about 25 to 26 watts and can be powered with this small solar panel, which typically is actually used to power only 2 CFLs or 1 incandescent bulb in the rural households as of now. So that's why this is a game-changing opportunity in the energy access debate, not only in India but also globally. So there are two main reasons why this system would make sense. One, with the same capital investment, you're actually providing significantly higher energy services. So in the typical conventional system, with this panel, all you could give is one lighting point or two lighting points at most. That's it. But related to that, this is a huge energy service improvement. That's number one. And number two, from the private sector perspective, the risk that the private sector takes in the off-grid market essentially is equivalent to the solar panels. So with the same risk profile for the private sector, one can actually increase the energy services. And secondly, even if the grid electricity comes to villages or those areas, then the super efficient appliances are still going to stay, and they're still going to continue saving electricity. So which is not really the case in the conventional off-grid solar energy access market, which essentially comprises only of the lighting points, one or two lighting points. So when the grid comes, the usability of that entire system essentially goes away. And the third key aspect of the super efficient system in the off-grid space is because since you're avoiding the solar panel investment, the avoided cost of electricity is very high in the off-grid space, and that's why super efficient appliances have a very high value in the off-grid space than in the regular grid sector.